Hello and welcome back to Superstar Glam. I know it's been a while, a long while. Like I've missed this. So that's why today I wanted to do this chit chat, get ready with me, just to explain what's been going on, why I haven't been on here. If you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Janice. I really hope that you will subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. In the meantime, let's get started with this Get Ready With Me. So, taking off my glasses, I wear a contact wear. So right now I can't even tell if it's recording or not. Honestly, I'm too lazy to get up and put my contacts on. So that's why I'm doing it like this. But anyways, yeah, I wanted to come on here because I know I have not been doing anything lately. And I guess I just wanted to talk about it, and instead of just jumping on a tutorial, I just wanted to just talk a little bit about what's been going on. I'm just moisturizing my face. So much has been going on. I've been gone for so long, but it's really because when the summer comes, it's really, really hard for me to find time for myself. We have a very small house, and I have four children. I have a 18-year-old all the way down to a 4-year-old. So my life is pretty busy, and I feel like most of the time I'm spending it in the kitchen. When they're home, they're always hungry. They always want this, they always want that. To me, it's like I feel like I'm barely taking a break after they've had breakfast, and then they're already coming saying that they're hungry again. So it's just too chaotic. So I find it really, really hard. The weekends, it's almost the same thing. I really don't have like my own space or my own time to do it. So it just, and then on top of that, like I feel guilty like closing the door and telling people, like telling my kids not to interrupt me. I feel guilty. Like they're on their break and I wanna spend time with them and just relax, you know, with them. So that's kind of what I do. I kind of enjoy the summer for them, I mean, with them. So that's pretty much what I've been doing, just doing that. I mean, I've had other things going on that, I don't know, they kind of put a damper on things. A lot of drama in my life, and just don't feel motivated. There's a lot of stuff that I can't talk about. That I go on. So I'm not gonna say that I get depressed, because I know that that's a serious thing, and I just don't want to say, oh yeah, I get depressed, because you know, reality is that I do get low at times, but I have my highs too, and I have more highs than I do lows. So you know, I'll have like my meltdown days, or one day, you know, where I'll just let it all out. I vent. I say what's on my mind. I talk about it. I cry about it. I feel sorry for myself. And then after I've let it all out, I feel better. And then I say, well, I could be worse off. And I'm not, you know? So, I pick myself up and I move on. Because as a mom, you know, if you're a parent, you know exactly what that feels like. You can't always have bad days, you know. You have to pick yourself up, not do it for yourself, but do it for your kids. So that's kind of been my roller coaster. I actually got this foundation from my cousin that she bought it, and it oxidated and it ended up being too dark for her. So it does look like it kind of comes off light on me, but it oxidizes and it actually works out really good. And I've actually really been liking it. It's the Urban Decay Naked Skin Weightless Ultra Definition Liquid Makeup. And I never tried it before, so it's been nice. I actually been liking how my skin looks. I haven't been wearing a lot of makeup either. Just bare face every single day. So I'm actually really excited, and I've been missing all of this. I want to get back on here. I just want to move on. It's enough time to dwell, and you know, I just want to get over my funk, get inspired. Fall colors are inspiring me right now. Vampy lips, I want it all. Oh, I did change my hair, in case you haven't noticed. It wasn't coming off. What started off as me wanting blue hair turned out to and ended up being turquoise, because I didn't want to do the whole stripping my hair to the lightest it could possibly just be, and just so that I could have blue hair. So when I was applying the blue, it was turning turquoise, which I didn't mind. I liked the color. So anyways, it was just doing that. It was just staying there, and I was like, I needed to retouch my hair. It was looking a little dull, and you could totally see my my growth. So I decided to use the blue that I was using plus red that I had when I was dyeing my hair red, mix it together, and I got this shade, which is, I actually like it. It was a little bit getting used to, because it's so dark, so it looks like almost black, but when I go out in the sun or light hits it, it actually looks like a nice purple. It's still pretty dark, but I'm sure as I wash it, it'll keep getting lighter. Oh, I wanted to try a new concealer. I have this little drawer here with all products that I've been wanting to try, that I've kind of been picking up here and there, of all products that I want to try. So the concealer is actually from ColourPop. It's their new launch. I picked it up in the shade medium 30. Anything else that's been going on? It's like, I don't want to bring my unhappiness here onto my channel. Like, I want this to be like my escape of my reality, basically. I haven't really, I mean, except for the few things that I've been getting here and there, I haven't really been shopping for anything. I like this concealer. Has good coverage, but I think I'm going to mix in a lighter shade, because I do use a lighter concealer to lighten under my eye. I'm going to use this one because I haven't been using it, and it's... I want to finish it. It's the Urban Decay Naked Skin Weightless Complete Coverage Concealer in Light Neutral. I guess the only thing that I could share more about why I don't post during the summer, because I'm sure it probably sounds to some people like, oh, I just don't want to, you know, do the work or I'm lazy and I'm sure I could find time or whatever. It's a little more complicated than that. I have four kids, like I've mentioned. Three of my kids have special needs. So it requires a little bit more of, you know, me being, not on top of them, but being, looking out for them, you know. We can't rely on them. One of the oldest one, he literally will starve himself and not worry about drinking water, and he suffers from dehydration if we're not on top of him, reminding him to drink water and fluids and eat properly, you know. So I still have to constantly be reminding him. Then, you know, then I have my daughter who takes medication every single day to control epilepsy, and she forgets, so I have to constantly remind her. And then I have my toddler who is on the autism spectrum, and of course he's a toddler, he's nonverbal, so he can't communicate, and so it requires a lot more attention, a lot more supervision. So my hands are really full. I got this little set from Cover Effects, and it comes in like little travel sizes, and I wanted to try their setting powder. This is a mattifying one. I also got the illuminating one. Well, I'm gonna try the mattifying one. Yeah, that's, I mean, it's a lot of personal stuff that I have to go through and do on a daily basis. So to find the time to actually, you know, be to myself and do this, I'm going to take the Milani Prep and Set and Glow Illuminating Transparent Powder. I'm just gonna use this to set the rest of my face. Actually, no, I'm not. I also have this that I wanted to try. It's the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Contour Stick. I just wanted to try. I do love to contour, so I'm always trying to find something that will work. I'm gonna take one of these from Royal and Langnickel and apply that to the stick and see. It's okay. I'm not wanting a fierce contour anyway, so except for these little products that I've been picking up here and there, I have actually been on a no buy kind of deal. I haven't really been feeling like things are worth it. I know holiday sets are coming out, but for example, Tarte is coming out with their same stuff that they've been coming out, like the blush collection, the little set that they sell in the cute packaging. I love the packaging. I am a sucker for packaging. But I think, do I really want another one? This would be my third year with the holiday blush palette from Tarte that I would have in my collection. How much blush do I need? We already know that Tarte does amazing blushes. So do I really need to pick it up? I don't think so. Eyeshadow palettes are almost the same thing. The only reason that I feel the need to pick up eyeshadow palettes is when I'm really excited for a collaboration and I definitely want to show my support, you know. For example, like I missed out on the Desi and Katie Dose of Colors collaboration. Now I'm gonna step the rest of my face. And I'm so bummed because, one, I love those girls. They're so inspiring, they're so funny and so talented, and I think that they did a really good job with the collab. So I was bummed that I missed out on the launch. I know they're restocking it at the end of this month, so I definitely want to get my hands on it. I also picked up from ColourPop the pressed powder face bronzer, and I got it in the shade California Dreaming, but I think I got it too warm. I don't know, we'll see how this looks. It looks like this. That packaging is actually really, really cute. Did I mention that I also got a new camera? I upgraded my camera. It's really pigmented. Yeah, I upgraded my camera, so I was actually really excited to try it out. I mean, I've been testing it out here and there, taking like, you know, little clips here and there, but I don't know what the final product's gonna look like until I import it and start editing. But I'm really, really excited. I was really excited about that, to use my little new camera. I'm excited about that. It's not bad. I'm gonna use this blush. It's from the from my subscription boxes. It's the Lychee and Gold Healthy Glow Rose Gold Blush Seraphine Botanicals. I guess Lychee and Gold is the shade name. Yes, that's what it is. Anyways, it looks really, really pretty. And I've been loving it with this brush. This is another subscription box item. It's the Luxie 640 Pro Precision Tapered. I love this brush. It's so flimsy and soft. The bristles are not dense at all. They're like really, really fluffy, which is why I love it for applying blush, because I don't like intense blush. And with this one, it's totally buildable because it's so fluffy. Just love it. Look at that. And that's actually a lot. It's been so long that I don't think I remember what my last video was about. So I don't even know what I've shared with you guys or not, because I did pick up some brushes from BH, from the Studio Pro line. Love these brushes. They're so good and soft. They're not scratchy at all. I picked up some face powders, brushes, and some eye brushes. They're so good. I've been using these like crazy. I love them. So I'm gonna prime my eyes with the MAC Pro Longwear Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. And I'm just doing a light wash of this. And also, just being stuck in my rut and not feeling inspired and whatever I was thinking or doing or procrastinating on, you know, it gave me also time to reflect and think about what I want to do, for example, on my channel. And you know what? I don't want to follow rules, because I've never been the type to follow rules. I mean, I follow rules. I'm not breaking any laws. Let's just say that. I just want to do me. What I love to do. What I like to do, want to share that, you know. I have so much that I want to share, but I'm always feeling like, well, I gotta do my, you know, reviews and my subscriptions and my this and my that. No, I'm gonna do whatever I want. If I want to do all tutorials, I love doing tutorials. That's all I'm gonna do. I want to do fun videos. I want to do challenges, and I just want to do a lot of things. I don't want to be so structured. Just whatever, whenever I turn on my camera and be like, well, today I'm gonna do this. That's what I'm gonna do. I guess this is more talking to myself. You know, not really talking to you guys. It's more like talking to myself, telling myself that that's what I want to do. It's more less structured and more fun, what I want to do, what feels right for me. Oh, anyways, so I have 3 new palettes. This is, I'm really excited. I can't believe that this was actually in our subscription box from BoxyCharm from last month. It is the Tarte Rainforest of the Sea Volume 2 eyeshadow palette. It's so pretty. And it has such pretty colors. Like neutral colors, you know, like everyday colors. So pretty. I can't believe that was in our subscription box. Then I picked up the ColourPop Yes Please palette. This is a similar palette to the Natasha Denona, the Sunset palette, but it's like $130. And this one had similar shades and it was only $16. So I got my hands on it. It's so pretty. It is so pretty. It has really pretty colors. And I actually swatched these and I was blown away. Like pigmentation, this palette is really good. I don't know if they're still selling it. I think they keep restocking it. I would totally recommend you getting this little palette. Totally worth it. And then Sephora was having a sale and they had these for I think $15. It's the Kat Von D Shade and Light Eye. I guess I'm into orange shades. It's so pretty, so pretty, and it's all matte except for this one here. I think it's a little shimmer. Like, I'm just going to do a simple eye. What I'll do is I'll do looks with the other palette for sure. Just to save some battery time, all I'm doing is I'm going to do my brows, my lashes. So I'll come back and do my lips on camera to finish up, okay? I'm going to use, I haven't used this one. This is, I think I got this at BoxyCharm subscription, and it's the ColourPop and Hello Kitty collab. It's the Ultra Satin Lip and Lock Diary, and it's this like really pretty pink. Since I'm wearing neutrals on my eyes, I figured I would wear a pop of pink on my lips. I'm gonna use this one. It's the NYX Mahogany lip liner. Sorry. I'm going to set my face with this, with the Cover FX Mattifying Spray. I don't like that spray. prayer. So this is it for the chit chat get ready with me. I just wanted to share a little bit about why I had not posted. I felt like this was going to be my transition back on here onto YouTube. I really hope that you will stay tuned for the rest of the videos that I have planned to share with you. So until next time, I will see you later. Bye.